Hello students, in the last lecture we completed the characteristics of chemical equilibrium, definition of chemical equilibrium and its characteristics. After that, what is the equilibrium constant, that is in terms of molar concentration Kc, in terms of partial pressure Kp. Okay, now once again we completed one more relation, that is the relation between Kc and Kp. Okay, so Kp is equal to Kc into RT whole to the power delta n g. Okay, now in this video now we are going to calculate some Kc and Kp expressions. Okay, now the question is given here, write the Kc and Kp expressions for the following reaction. N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. Now the Kc expression we know and Kp expression we know in the last video. Okay, now the product's concentration on the numerator divided by reactant's concentration on the denominator, and the concentration should be multiplied, and the stoichiometry coefficients raised to the power of the species. Okay, now here I am writing Kc is equal to, here the product is what, ammonia NH3, stoichiometry is 2, so that is raised to the power of NH3 whole divided by N2, stoichiometry 1, so power 1, need not to write, and H2, the stoichiometry is 3, so that's why I am writing 3 here. Now the next expression for Kp, now partial pressure of ammonia, stoichiometry 2, so square I am writing here power, and partial pressure of nitrogen gas in the denominator, stoichiometry is 1, and partial pressure of hydrogen, the stoichiometry will be here what, 3, so P³. Okay, now P is the pressure. Next one more, PCl5 gives PCl3 and Cl2, all are gaseous state. Okay, now I am writing Kc is equal to active mass of PCl3 multiplied by Cl2 divided by active mass of the PCl5. Now Kp expression, partial pressure of the PCl3 multiplied by partial pressure of the Cl2 gas divided by partial pressure of the PCl5 gas. Okay, now third question, hydrogen combined with iodine, this is iodine, to give hydrogen iodide. Now Kc expression, active mass of Hi square whole divided by active mass of H2 multiplied by active mass of I2. Okay, now Kp expression, partial pressure of Hi whole square whole divided by partial pressure of hydrogen gas multiplied by partial pressure of iodine gas. Okay, now in this fifth question, there is a solid CaCO3 which decomposes to give solid CaO and gaseous CO2. Do you know this is a heterogeneous equilibrium? We know type of equilibrium in last video, homogeneous and heterogeneous depending upon the phase of the, that is the physical state or phase of the reacting substances. Okay, the first three examples, if you see, all the substances exist in the same physical state, that's why they are under homogeneous equilibrium. Homogeneous equilibrium. Okay, now the fourth example is heterogeneous equilibrium. Now remember, the whatever the solid is there, pure solid and pure liquids, active mass is taken as unity, remember. So first of all I am writing general expression, Kc is equal to active mass of CaO multiplied by active mass of CO2 divided by active mass of CaCO3. Okay. Now here important thing is the CaO solid, CaCO3 also solid, so their concentrations are not taken in this expression because they are assumed to be unit concentrations. Are you getting my point? Now in the similar manner, if I am writing Kp, partial pressure of CaO multiplied by partial pressure of CO2 whole divided by partial pressure of CaCO3. Here also only the gaseous substance we can use the partial pressure instead of active mass. For solids and liquids it is assumed to be constant, and the constant value taken as unity. Constant value taken as what? Unity. Are you getting my point? Here the important note what I am writing here is, for pure solids, liquids, active mass is assumed to be unity. This is very important. Okay. Now, this is also heterogeneous equilibrium. Okay. Here also, I am writing Kc expression. So, ammonia active mass multiplied by H2S active mass. I am not writing divided by ammonium hydrogen sulfide because it is solid whose activity or active mass is taken as a unit. Now from Kp expression, partial pressure of ammonia multiplied by partial pressure of hydrogen sulfide. Okay. Now in the denominator I am not writing the partial pressure of ammonium hydrogen sulfide since it is a pure solid. Okay. Now here ester, ethyl estate hydrolysis in the presence of water to give acetic acid and ethyl alcohol. Okay. Now in this expression what we can write, Kc is equal to active mass of what? Acetic acid multiplied by active mass of ethyl alcohol whole divided by active mass of ethyl acetate. Okay. Now here why we are not taking the active mass of the pure water? We know pure water, that is a solvent, the activity or active mass is taken as a unity. So that's why we are not writing in the denominator. Now here we are not writing Kp expression here because Kp expression is only valid for gaseous species. Gaseous species, at least one of the reactants or products must be in the gaseous state, otherwise there is no any meaning of writing the Kp expression. That's why here what I am writing here, Kp has no meaning. Okay. Now come to one more heterogeneous, iron H2O gaseous state, iron oxide and H2. Okay. Now here also Kc expression, directly we can write active mass of hydrogen to the power 4 divided by active mass of water vapor to the power 4. The remaining Fe3O4 and Fe pure solids whose activity active mass is taken as a unity. Now here I am writing Kp expression also, partial pressure of hydrogen whole divided by to the power 4 whole divided by partial pressure of H2O to the power 4. H2O here steam, which is a ideal gas behavior. Okay. Now come to one more example, (2SO2) plus (O2) gives rise to (2SO3). Let's suppose all the participating substances are in which state? Gaseous state. Okay, we can write Kc expression as a active mass of sulfur trioxide whole to the power 2 whole divided by active mass of SO2 to the power 2 multiplied by active mass of oxygen. And Kp expression we can write partial pressure of SO3 whole square whole divided by partial pressure of SO2 whole square multiplied by partial pressure of O2. Partial pressure of what? O2. Now come to types of equilibrium constants. We know in the last video equilibrium constant Kp and equilibrium constant Kc. Apart from that, we have one more Kx and Kpc. Kx and Kpc. Okay. Now here, let's suppose consider a equilibrium reaction, small a moles of capital A combining with small b moles of a capital B to give small c moles of a capital D and small c moles of a capital C and small d moles of a capital D. Okay. Now here we know the expression of the Kc, that is capital C, that is the active mass of capital C power small c and active mass of capital D to the power small d whole divided by active mass of A to the power A, active mass of B to the power B in the last video. Okay. And similarly Kp is equal to partial pressure of C to the power C, partial pressure of D to the power D whole divided by partial pressure of A to the power small a and partial pressure of B to the power small b. So these two expressions we know, and from these two expressions we know the relation between Kp and Kc also. Okay. Now one more expression what I am writing here, Kx, where x is called mole fraction. Okay. So mole fraction of the mole fraction of the component C to the power small c, mole fraction of the component D, xd, to the power small d, mole fraction of component A, xa, to the power small a, mole fraction of component B, xb, power small b. Here the important thing is Kc is called equilibrium constant in molar concentration. Okay. Now what is the Kp? Equilibrium constant in partial pressures. Okay. Now the important thing is the Kx. What is the Kx? This is also equilibrium constant in mole fraction. What? In mole fraction. The xA, xB, xC and xD are the mole fractions. What? Mole fractions of A, B, C, D reacting substances. Okay. Now, what is the relation between Kp and Kc? In the last video, we derive a relation between Kp and Kc. Do you know? What is the relation? Kp is equal to Kc into RT whole to the power delta NG. Yes or no? Yes or no? In the last video, Kp is equal to Kc into RT whole to the power delta NG. So we know the relation. So I am not deriving here. Okay. If you have any doubt, go to the second video. So in which I derived the relation between Kp and Kc. Now the important relation, that is relation between Kp and Kc. kx. This is very important relation. So the first relation between kp and kc, and the second relation between kp and kx. Okay. Now, do you know what is the partial pressure? It is the pressure exerted by the gas alone when it occupies the total volume of the container. Okay. Partial pressure will be equal to the product of the total pressure multiplied by mole fraction. We know in the Dalton's law of partial pressures. Okay. Now here, shall I write partial pressure of A is equal to total pressure of the mixture into mole fraction of A. Similarly, partial pressure of B is equal to total pressure at equilibrium multiplied by mole fraction of B. And similarly, partial pressure of C is equal to total pressure of the mixture at equilibrium multiplied by mole fraction of the C. And partial pressure of D equal to total pressure of at equilibrium multiplied by mole fraction of the D. Okay. Now, what is the Kp expression? Once again, Kp is equal to partial pressure of C raised to small c, partial pressure of D to the power small d, and partial pressure of A to the power small a, and partial pressure of B to the power small b. Okay. Now, in this expression, I am writing Pa, Pb, Pc, Pd values in terms of total pressure and mole fraction. Okay. Now, Pc, shall I write P total multiplied by mole fraction of C whole power small c, and similarly P total multiplied by mole fraction of D whole power small d whole divided by P total into mole fraction of component A to the power small a multiplied by P total mole fraction of B whole to the power small b. Okay. Now here what I am writing, Kp is equal to, here I am writing xc power small c xd power small d whole divided by xa power small a into xb power small b. Okay. And again we are writing p total whole to the power, in the numerator we have c plus d, minus of, in the denominator we have a plus b. Okay. Now here Kp is equal to, this term will be Kx. This is the Kx. This is the what? Kx. Okay. Now that expression, that value I am writing Kx multiplied by P total whole to the power delta n g. Delta n g. So this is a very useful relation between the Kp and Kx. Kp and Kx. Now here, the relation between Kp and Kx depend upon the delta Ng value. Depending upon the delta Ng value. Delta Ng may be greater than 0. Delta Ng may be less than 0. Delta Ng may be equal to 0. Let's suppose we are dealing with case 1. Now here, the base, that is a P total, this is the equilibrium total pressure. Okay. This is, let's suppose, greater than 1. Then the Kp Kc relation decided by the delta Ng value. Delta Ng value, suppose delta Ng value 0, so Kp Kc both are, sorry, Kp and Kx, Kp and Kx both are equal. Okay. Now if the delta Ng greater than 0, then Kp greater than what? Kx. Okay, now if delta ng less than 0, then kp less than kx. This is the first case where p total greater than 1. Okay, now in the second case, if the total pressure at equilibrium less than 1, then delta ng 0, so kp equal to kx, delta ng greater than 0, so kp less than kx. This is very important. If delta ng less than 0, then kp greater than kx. This is the relation between kp and kx. Okay, now one more case is there. Let's suppose total pressure at equilibrium is equal to 1, then irrespective of the delta ng, kp is always equal to kx. For all delta ng that is greater than 0, less than 0, is equal to 0. For all these three cases, kp is equal to kx. Kp is equal to what? Kx. This is very important. Now here, one objective question is there. Kp and Kc depends on temperature. Kp value, Kc value depends on temperature. Okay, at constant temperature, Kp, Kc have constant values. This is very important. Unless until temperature is not changes, then Kp, Kc do not changes, constant values. Okay, even though pressure, volume, pressure, volume, concentration or catalyst may be changes. If you change the pressure, if you change the volume, if you change the concentration, if you change the catalyst, okay, but the Kp, Kc value remains constant since temperature is constant. This is very important. But here, but Kx depends on temperature and also on pressure, okay, provided condition delta ng should not be equal to 0. Okay, let's suppose even at constant temperature is constant, kh will changes by changing the total pressure. Kh will change by changing total pressure at equilibrium provided delta ng not equal to 0. So this is a very important statement. The KH value changes with changing of the pressure. Total pressure at equilibrium, even though temperature is constant. Are you getting my point? Here, what is the relation between Kp and KH? Kp is equal to KH multiplied by P total whole to the power delta Ng. Delta Ng. Now, delta Ng, let's suppose greater than 0. This is the first case. Because delta Ng is not equal to 0, that means maybe greater than 0, maybe less than 0. Okay, now at constant temperature, temperature is still constant. If pressure is increased, KH will decrease. KX will decrease. Are you getting my point? How? Here in this expression you see, Kp is always constant at a constant temperature. Because we are keeping the temperature constant, that means Kp should always constant. Okay. Now here, delta Ng greater than 0. Okay. Now this total pressure value, what I am increasing? This value increasing. Okay. This value increasing. Now the Kp value to maintain constant, KH value definitely should decrease. So the sum of the product of increase and decrease become what? Constant. Are you getting my point? If the total pressure increases, P total increases, so this term will increase. When this term will increase, the total value Kp should kept constant, that means KH value should decrease. The KH value should, what happens? Decrease. This is the first case. Okay. Now come to second case. If the delta Ng less than 0. If the delta Ng less than 0. Okay. Now, I am taking an example. N2 plus 3H2 give equilibrium 2NH3. Here also you can take the example like PCl5 gives PCl3 plus Cl2. Here delta Ng, what happens? Sum of the number of moles of gaseous products minus reactants, that will be 1. So if you put the delta Ng 1, here Kp is equal to what? Kx into P total. Are you getting my point? If the total pressure at equilibrium increases, to keep the Kp constant, the KH value should, what happens? Decrease. Okay. Now in this second case, the delta Ng value, sum of the number of moles of gaseous products minus reactants, that will be minus 2. Okay. Let's suppose the relation is Kp is equal to Kx into P total to the power what? Delta Ng. Delta Ng minus 2, Kx into P total to the power minus 2. That means Kp is equal to Kx 1 upon P total whole square. P total whole square. Are you getting my point? Now here, in this situation, same. At constant temperature. Again the temperature is constant. When the temperature is constant, that means Kp is always constant. Okay. Now here, total pressure at equilibrium total pressure at equilibrium, let's suppose increases. That means the denominator value, what happens? Increases. So to keep the Kp constant, numerator value should also increase. That's why the ratio become what? Constant. Are you getting my point? Then Kx will be increases. Are you getting my point? So the Kh value, that is the Kx value, depending upon pressure also. Temperature, that is common for Kc, Kp and Kx. But Kc, Kp independent on the pressure. But Kx will depend on the pressure, provided delta Ng not equal to zero. Not equal to zero. Okay, now here I'm taking equilibrium constant in terms of both concentration and pressure. The equilibrium constant in terms of concentration and pressure is called KPC. KPC. Equilibrium constant in terms of pressure as well as concentration. Let's suppose I have A, B two reactants, C, D two products. Okay. Let's suppose among these four species, let's suppose A is in aqueous state and the rest of the remaining three in the gaseous state. Let's suppose. Then we have gas, we have aqueous medium as well as gaseous medium. Okay. Now in this case, generally, if we write the Kc expression, concentration of C multiplied by D multiplied divided by A into B. Okay. Now here concentration shall write the partial pressure by RT. We know from ideal gas equation PV is equal to what? nRT. So P is equal to what? N by V RT. So N by V is equal to P by RT. N by V is nothing but number of moles per unit volume, that is active mass, that will be partial pressure by R into T. Okay. Now PC by RT, PD by RT. Okay. Now A is a aqueous, so we should not write in terms of partial pressure. Only for gases we can write the partial pressure. Now PB divided by RT. Okay. Now here we are now writing the Kc. Now RT, one RT will be cancelled, one RT will be left by cross multiplication. Kc into RT is equal to Pc into Pd divided by active mass of A into partial pressure of B. This Kc into RT, now this is a special equilibrium constant, which is a equilibrium constant in terms of partial pressure and molar concentration, that is equal to Pc into Pd divided by active mass of A multiplied by partial pressure of B. Are you getting my point? Now here Kp can exist only for that equilibrium which satisfies these two conditions. What are the conditions? Now the first condition is एटलीस्ट द फर्स्ट कंडीशन इज एटलीस्ट वन ऑफ द एटलीस्ट वन ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट और प्रोडक्ट शुड बी इन गैस फेज should be in gas phase then only we have to use kp expression next to no component of the equilibrium no component of the equilibrium should be in solution phase these are the two conditions so we can write kp exist only when at least one of the reactant or product should be in the gas phase no component of the equilibrium should be in the solution phase let's suppose if solution phase is present the equilibrium constant would be kpc if solution phase is present then the equilibrium constant is called KPC. This is a special type of equilibrium constant which involves aqueous which involves solution phase as well as gas phase. Now the important one is the units. What are the units of KP and KC? This is very important. Now KP units generally pressure is expressed in the atmosphere so I am writing KP is equal to atmosphere whole to the power delta ng okay now KC molar concentration that is the moles per liter whole to the power delta ng okay now what about the kx unitless because mole fraction has no units it is a ratio between the mole fraction of the products divided by the mole fraction of the reactants now here important thing is in standard state we can write the equilibrium constant kc not superscript 0 that is a standard condition that is the kc normal divided by the standard molar concentration what is the standard molar concentration 1 mole per liter okay now here same if you see standard condition units for kp also we can write kp whole divided by standard pressure is 1 bar this is the standard condition okay now that's why here we should not write the units for kp and kc because in standard state So whatever we are writing the KC naught, KP naught, they are with respect to the standard condition. Okay, in terms of magnitude, KC naught equal. That's why. We should not write the units for KP and KC. Actually, the KP and KC corresponding to the standard condition. That's why we should not write the units. Okay, now the important topic is the characteristics of equilibrium constant. This is very important for objective point of view. Okay, characteristics. Now the expression for equilibrium constant K is applicable only when concentration of all the participating species attain their equilibrium values and do not change with time. Okay, because at equilibrium, when the system attain the equilibrium, there will be no change in the concentration, no change in the pressure, no change in the volume, etc. Okay, now the second point, the value of the equilibrium constant is independent on the initial concentration. This is very important. Initial concentration of the reactants, products, presence, absence of catalyst, independent. Okay, now the equilibrium constant has unique value for a particular reaction represented by balanced equation at a constant temperature. This is very important. Unless until temperature do not changes, Kp, Kc do not change. This is very important. Now the equilibrium constant value independent on the direction from which the equilibrium is attained. Are you getting my point? Next, it is the measure of the extent which a reaction proceeds in forward or backward direction. The main significance of the equilibrium constant is the extent of completion of the reaction. Okay, now the greater the value of the equilibrium constant, greater the completion of the reaction in forward direction. Okay, now the K value increases, the extent of reaction in forward direction will increases. Okay, now what are the factors which do not influence the equilibrium constant? This is very important. Now here, just now I told you, concentration of reactants, products do not change the equilibrium constant. The pressure, volume do not change the equilibrium constant except Kx. Here the equilibrium constant Kc or Kp. Okay, Kx will change by changing the pressure provided delta Ng not equal to zero. Presence of the catalyst also, equilibrium constant do not changes. Addition of inert gases at constant pressure, constant volume also, equilibrium constant do not changes. Are you getting my point? Now what factors influence the equilibrium constant? There are three factors. The first factor is the mode of representation of a chemical reaction. Okay, now number two, stoichiometry of the reaction. Number three, temperature. Okay, out of these three, this is the third point, this is very important point, temperature. Okay, now what is the mode of representation of a chemical reaction? Now when a chemical reaction is reversed, let's suppose a chemical reaction get reversed, then its equilibrium constant will be inverted. Here we have A plus B gives C plus D. The equilibrium constant is what? K1. The equilibrium constant is what? K1. If you interchange the reactants and products, that means the reaction, what happens? Reverse. Then the equilibrium constant will get what? Inverted. Now let's suppose K1 is equal to product of the concentration of the products divided by product of the concentration of the reactants. Yes or no? Now this is corresponding to equilibrium 1. Now come to, this is the equilibrium constant for corresponding equation 1. Let's suppose this is K2. Now K2, what I am writing here? Product of the concentration of the products, that is A into B, by reactants C into D. Okay, this is equation 2, this is equation 1. Now here, if you multiply it 1 into 2, so you will get K1 into K2 is equal to what? 1. So K2 is equal to obviously 1 by K1. K2 is equal to obviously what? 1 by K1. K2 is the new equilibrium constant. Let's suppose here the equilibrium constant, this is K2. The K2 value is equal to what happens? 1 by K1. K2 value become what happens? 1 by K1. Let's suppose I have one example. Now N2 plus O2 gives, that is the equilibrium, 2NO. Now the equilibrium constant value 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. Now the question is, what is the equilibrium constant value for the reaction 2NO gives rise to N2 plus O2? This is the question mark. Okay. Now here, if you carefully observe the reaction, the first reaction, if you reverse the first reaction, you will get the second reaction. That means in the second reaction, whatever the Kc, let's suppose this is Kc dash, will be inverted of reciprocal of first one. So 1 by 2 into 10 raised to minus 2, 100 by 2, that is the 50. This type of questions are very important. If the reaction is reversed, the equilibrium constant will be inverted. That is very important. Okay, that is the first mode of representation of chemical reaction. Okay, next, number 2, stoichiometry of the reaction. This is very important. Method of writing the equation of a reversible reaction is referred as what? Stoichiometry of the reaction. Now, let's suppose when we multiply reaction by a suitable integer, let's suppose a factor n, then the new equilibrium constant will be equal to the nth power of the previous equilibrium constant. That means, let's suppose I am taking one example, A equilibrium B. Now the equilibrium constant, let's suppose this is the K. Now what I am doing, I am multiplying with a n factor. Multiplying with what? N factor. Let's suppose I am multiplying with n on both sides. Okay, then what is the new equilibrium? Let's suppose this is K1, this is K2. Now I want to write the relation between K1 and K2. Okay, now what is the K1 here? B upon A. Okay, what is the K2 here? B to the power N upon A to the power N. Shall I write B by A whole to the power what? N. So here K2 is equal to, shall I write K1? This is the K1 power what? N. That means the new equilibrium constant value will be equal to the nth power of the previous equilibrium constant. That means K2 will be equal to the nth power of the previous equilibrium constant. Okay, let's suppose one problem we have. Now here SO2 plus half O2 to give SO3. The equilibrium constant here is 5. Now, what is the equilibrium constant for 2SO2 plus O2 to give 2SO3? All are gaseous species. Okay. Now, what is the equilibrium constant here? Now, if you carefully observe the equation 1, SO2 plus half O2 gives SO3. If you multiply it with 2 on both sides, so you will get the second equilibrium. That means whatever the factor you are multiplying, that factor will be raised to the power. So the Kc will be 5 raised 5 power 2, that is 5 square, that is 25. Are you getting my point? This is Kc, this is Kc dash. Let's suppose this is Kc dash. Are you getting my point? So Kc dash is equal to what? Kc whole power 2, because we are multiplying with n factor 2. Okay, now one more question I am writing here. Let's suppose I have H2 plus I2 equilibrium 2HI. The equilibrium constant value I have 49. Now my question is, what is the equilibrium constant for the HI decomposition to give half H2 and half I2? What is the equilibrium constant? All are gaseous species. Okay, half H2 plus half I2. Now, if you carefully observe the equation 2 and equation 1, if you reverse the equation 2 and reverse the equation 2, 2HI, HI gives half H2 and half I2. Are you getting my point? Now here, in this case, the KC first of all inverted. Okay, now here the stoichiometry will be 2, here stoichiometry will be 1. That means you are multiplying with which factor? 1 by n, that is 1 by 2. So the power will be 1 by 2. So that is the 1 by, just wait, root 49, that is the 1 by 7. Are you getting my point? You are multiplying with what? 1 by 2. Whatever the number n is there, whatever the number is there, that will be raised to the power. Okay. Now, same concept here, division concept here. Which concept is there here? Division concept is there. Okay. Then the power will be root of the nth of the previous equilibrium constant. Let's suppose A gives B. The equilibrium condition, let's suppose K. Now I am dividing by N or multiplied by 1 by N. Both are same. Are you getting my point? Then what will be the equilibrium constant of the second reaction? That is the K to the power 1 by N, root of N, nth root. What is the answer here? Nth root of the previous equilibrium constant. Okay, this is corresponding to this question. Actually, this question, H2 plus I2 2HI, that is the, actually this model question. Okay, now here, let's suppose I have 2NO gives N2 plus O2. Okay, now the KC value 25. Now what is the NO decomposed to half N2 half O2 equilibrium constant? Now you are multiplying with 1 by 2 or dividing with 2. So whatever the concept is same, then the equilibrium constant, that is the new equilibrium constant, will be the nth power of the nth root of the, if you take n as a divisible value, okay, so 1 by 2. That means here 25 to the power half, that is the under root 25, nothing but what? 5. Okay, now third one, when individual reactions, let's suppose a reaction has two or more steps. If we adding all these steps, then you will get a overall reaction, that is a net reaction. Then how to find the net reaction equilibrium constant? Let's suppose we have A to B one reaction, next to B to C, next to C to D. Now each step individually equilibrium constants are K1, K2, K3. Let's suppose I want to calculate the total overall reaction, that is the net reaction equilibrium constant. By adding these three reactions, BB gets cancelled, CC gets cancelled, so A gives D. The equilibrium constant K for overall reaction, that is the net reaction, is the product of the multiply their equilibrium constants, that is K1 into K2 into K3. Are you getting my point? Let's suppose I am taking one example. I have phosphoric acid. We know phosphoric acid is a tribasic acid. Now in the first step, it ionizes as a H+ and H2PO4-. In the second step, H2PO4- dissociated into H+ plus HPO4-. In the third step, HPO4- dissociated to give H+ and PO4-. Are you getting my point? Now here the equilibrium constant, let's suppose randomly I am taking 2, randomly roughly I am taking here 3, here the equilibrium constant I am taking 4. Now the question is, H3PO4 dissociated to give 3H+ plus PO4-. What is the equilibrium constant here? If you see the first three reactions, if you add the first three reactions, you will get the net reaction. Are you getting my point? That means the overall K value will be the multiple of the individual step up reactions. The K1 value 2 into 3 into 4. Okay, 2, 3 is 6, 6, 4 is 24. 6, 4 is 24. Are you getting my point? Now, here, let's suppose I have one problem. N2 plus 3H2 equilibrium 2NH3. N2 plus O2 equilibrium 2NO. H2 plus half O2 equilibrium H2O. Okay, now here the equilibrium constant, here K1 given, here K2 given, here K3 given. The question is, find equilibrium constant for the following reaction. What is the reaction given here? 2NH3 plus 5/2 O2 equilibrium 2NO plus 3H2O. This is the reaction to which we have to find the equilibrium constant. First of all, this is our main reaction. Okay, now ammonia, where ammonia is present in the first reaction. So ammonia in the first reaction, it is present on the right side, but we have to convert the ammonia, we have to transfer the ammonia to left side. So first of all, I am interchanging the reactants products in the first reaction. Once the reaction is reversed, the equilibrium constant will be inverted, that is 1 by K1. Are you getting my point? Now, one more important thing, NO stoichiometry 2, here is also 2. NO is right side, here is also right side. Okay, now write the second reaction as usual. N2 plus O2 2NO equilibrium constant is K2. Now come to third reaction. What is the stoichiometry of water molecule? 3. So I have to multiply the third equation by 3 on both sides. Why? Because I need 3H2O. Okay, that's why I am multiplying the equation number 3 by 3. 3H2 plus 3/2 O2 equilibrium 3H2O. So the K3 What is the n value here? 3. So that will be raised to the power of the previous equilibrium constant, that is the K3 to the power 3. Now what I am doing, I am adding all these three reactions. Now you see here N2 gets cancelled. Yes, 3H2 will get cancelled here. Yes, and what we have left here on the left side, 2NH3, O2 plus 3/2. So 1 plus 3/2, 5/2, that is 5/2 O2 equilibrium. On the right side we have 2NO plus 3H2O. What is the overall equilibrium constant here? When we adding the three reactions, we have to multiply the individual equilibrium constant, that is 1 by K1 multiplied by K2 multiplied by K3 whole cube. This is the final answer. Okay, so here we completed the two factors which are affecting the equilibrium constant. What are the factors affecting the equilibrium constant? Number one, mode of the representation of a chemical reaction. When the chemical reaction is what? Reversed, the equilibrium constant will be inverted. Now the stoichiometry, if you multiply it with any number, then that number will be raised to the power of the previous equilibrium constant. If you divide with any suitable number, then that number will be goes to the nth root of the previous equilibrium constant. If you add two or more reactions to get the net reaction, then the net reaction equilibrium constant will be the overall net reaction equilibrium constant will be the multiple of all the individual equilibrium constants. Okay, now in the next video we will discuss about the temperature effect, that is the dependence of equilibrium constant on